Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Today, beloved, we read a beautiful word from the Bible, the New Testament, Revelation. The Revelation 1 chapter, 1 verse 9. A very important book of life, that is the Bible, here is directing us as we read in Revelation 1 9. In the isle that is called Patmos, for the word of God, a very mighty word of God is revealed over here from the revelation that is in the isle that is called Patmos for the word of God. Yes, can we not imagine how eagerly John would lay himself out for a life of incessant service for his divine master and Lord? Yes, it is an incessant service for his divine master and Lord Jesus Christ. Yes, no task would seem too great, no toil too arduous, if only he and his Lord might be glorified. Yes, Jesus Christ was to be glorified, and John was sent for this mission. And we can well imagine how all his plans, ambitions, desires would center round the extension of the kingdom of Jesus Christ. Then suddenly, Patmos. Yes, Patmos, as we read in Revelation, yes, and what now became of all his hopes and longings, his plans and projects? Surely he buried them all as he set foot on Patmos. Yes, they died when he first heard his sentence. They were interred with no prospect of a resurrection. Patmos was for the beloved discipline. Yes, it was for discipline and disciple. Yes, here we read that it is the island of buried hopes, as it is called. Patmos, an island. It is an island. Yes, but John soon discovered that Patmos had its compensations. Always look towards the bright side of life, my dear beloved. Do not be sorrowful where you are. Wherever you are, look as an opportunity that Jesus Christ is providing you for your future. He's opening up a way for you, for he is the way, the truth and the life. John 14:6, and he is the living God, as read in Luke chapter 20 verse 38. So what does the word say? Only believe. Mark 5 verse 36, and he will bless you abundantly. Yes, true, he could no longer, that is John, no longer could entertain the hope of carrying out all his plans. Yet he learned in Patmos that the truer and nobler service would yet be his than any he had ever contemplated. To him would be yet be his. Yes, the last thought he had was he was at Patmos, and it was an island of buried hopes. But he looked towards the brighter side of life. To him came the assurance that not only has the Lord loved us and washed us from our sins in his own blood, but he hath set us apart as both kings and priests, and nothing can ever terminate that royal priesthood. The blessings are already yours. Yes, beloved, the blessings are there. He's calling you, Jesus Christ, to bless you. John had caught sight of a far greater honor and holier service awaiting him in the land that lies beyond. It might have been thought that John, in his dreary exile, was terribly isolated. Someone had said, not isolated, but insulated. An important point to be noted. John was not isolated, but insulated. And there is a world of difference between the two. This too, isolated and insulated. Yes, true, the island was small and his confines narrow. But that was only the outer circumstances of his life, his daily environment. Nothing to see. Alone, alone, alone. Yes, John was alone. There was silence. Imagine John alone on the island of Patmos, and nobody there, and there was all quietness. And but John found it not so. The overwhelming glory of the sight of his risen Lord robed him of his strength until he felt the grace, gentle pressure of his strength until, yes, the grace of a gentle pressure of the pierced hand resting upon him. Yes, Jesus Christ is besides each one of us. We are not alone. Remember, my dear brother, sister, my dear youngster, my dear child, you are not alone. Jesus Christ is there with you. Again and again he tells us that he heard a voice speaking to him. Willis, these things were so he could, yes, never feel that there was nothing to see. He could never feel alone. Yes, be encouraged. Yes, beloved, you're never alone. Jesus Christ is there with you in every situation, in every circumstances, in your sorrow, in your sickness. Jesus Christ is there with you. He is a loving Father. He is a loving God and a loving Mother. As read in Isaiah 66 verse 13, he comforts us as a loving Mother. Yes. And the Spirit so insulated John that God's messages might pass through him to the entire world. Yes. What an inspiration. What a motivation. Yes. The messages, we read Revelation today. And whoever reads the Revelation and whoever hears Revelation is blessed, as we read in Revelation chapter 1. And Jesus Christ is the Alpha and the Omega, as we read in Revelation 1:8 and Revelation 22 chapter. Most of us are well acquainted with this experience. We may not have had to suffer at the hands of an earthly potentate, had to bury their fondest hopes, their most eager desires. Yes, also, O weary, troubled heart, if God has led you to the island of buried hopes, it is that he may show you yet more wonderful things. Yes, pay attention over here. It says, if you are in the buried hope island, but there is much more wonderful revelation and wonderful things for you. Yes, Jesus Christ is going to bless you. He has not failed you, nor forgotten you, but he has led you into the darkest room, because in his own time and way, he would reveal to you the unsuspected glory of his grace and power. Yes, you will receive the glory and the power and the strength. Is our life lonely? Is it monotonous? We need open eyes. Standing near us all the time is the same wonderful Lord Jesus Christ, who stood by John in Patmos. Yes, in the loneliness, Jesus Christ was there with John. The same Jesus Christ is there with you. He's with me. We are not alone. Yes, for he will never leave us nor forsake us. As read in Joshua 1:9 and Deuteronomy 31:6 says, do not be afraid, do not be frightened, or do not be discouraged. Yes, it is a commandment for us. And it says, behave courageously. As read in 2 Chronicles 19 verse 11. It is saying to us, when do we receive the blessing? It says in Joshua chapter 1 verse 7, it says, behave courageously and love the Lord Jesus Christ. Yes, love the Lord your God with all your heart, mind, soul and strength, and he will bless you wherever you go. Yes, let us grab this word. Keep your hand on the verse which is there. Yes, and read the Bible, my dear brother, sister, and also pray, and Jesus Christ will bless you. Oh, the joy even of Patmos, when it is filled with the presence of Jesus. So anywhere we may be, in darkness or in light, always remember Jesus Christ is there with you. Jesus Christ is the light of the world, John 8:12. Yes, Patmos has its compensations. So we are not just left high and dry, but we have our remuneration. We have our compensation. But if we would share in them, and Patmos is to be a blessing to us, we must fulfill certain conditions. And here is the secret, that in our disappointments, suffering, monotonousness, and loneliness, love Christ. Yes. And also, we will find Jesus Christ is there with us. Also, we find that to those who fulfill these conditions, there is no Patmos that is not radiated by a glory that is not of the earth. So the glory of Jesus Christ will be upon us. Our Father makes no mistake. Yes, he is a God full of authority. As we read in Matthew 28, every authority in heaven and earth belongs to him. May Jesus Christ bless each of us. Amen.